Umbrella is the first part of a three-part trilogy of novels about the relationship between technological advance, warfare, and mental illness. And what the proposition I am advancing through this series of novels is that the way to understand technological advance is not as something that human beings are doing, but rather something that's being done to us with various consequences. But of course, the books aren't kind of like that. That makes it sound like they're very, you know, didactic and very kind of preachy. The books are immersive. They're about taking readers right inside somebody's mind and inside somebody's body and really feeling with them. The book is almost a single block of text. It has a paragraph break about every four or five pages. I'm not quite sure where that came from. It seemed right for the subject matter. Another thing that happens in the text is that you move from one character's mind to another character with no explanation. You just switch. And it seemed to be part of the same thing, this fluidity and movement. In Umbrella, Parapluie, there are some paragraphs. In the next book, there are none. When I was a child, I would go to the library and read science fiction books. And J.G. Ballard's books were always shelved with all the other science fiction. And I read them when I was very young, when I was 12, 13, and didn't really understand how important they were. And then I reread them in my 20s. And Ballard was really the writer who showed me the way forward. You know, I could see nobody else who was, I'm talking about the early 1980s, nobody else who was writing at that time had that strength of vision, that and that understanding of the contemporary world. When I was a little bit older, I met him and he became my mentor, you know, so he's, and you know, he died a few years ago, but he is the most important influence on my work, so much so that sometimes if I read my own stuff back, I'm a bit shocked to see how influential he's been. Joyce is very different. I think a lot of people assume because there is the quotation from Joyce in the book, and because superficially it looks like it may have some similarities to Ulysses, that this is a very Joycean book. It isn't really. I think like a lot of the modernists though, like Joyce, Virginia Woolf, Wyndham Lewis, I reacted against the conventions of fiction. The way everything is told in the past, the way everything's told by a narrator. That's not what my life is like. So my reason for writing in this style is emotional. It's not because I've read James Joyce. I've read bits and pieces. I've been translated into French now for well over 20 years. I've worked with three translators into French. I can see that they have different approaches, but I'm not competent to properly assess a translation. It's very difficult because sometimes if I'm talking to a translator, I will see how they've translated one small thing and it's wrong. It's just wrong, okay? But they see a bigger picture. They may have to make something wrong in order to make something bigger right. So it's very wrong for somebody who isn't totalement couramment to judge a translation.